This afternoon, we celebrate the Vigil Mass for the fifth Sunday of Lent. Remember in a special way at this Mass, the Noble and Roberts families. Our celebrant is Father John. Please rise and join in our opening hymn of order 22 to break the bread and milk. Or in your worship aid, how great thou art. 422.
The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. I will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt. For they broke my covenant, and I had to show myself their master, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will place my law within them and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have to need to teach their friends and relatives how to know the Lord. All, from least to greatest, shall know me, says the Lord. For I will forgive their evil doing and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Some Greeks who had come to worship at the Passover feast came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and asked him, "Sir, we would like to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew, then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life loses it, and whoever hates his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me. I am troubled now. Yet what should I say? Father, save me from this hour. But it was for this purpose that I came to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven, "I have glorified it and will glorify it again." The crowd there heard it and said it was thunder. But others said, "An angel has spoken to him." Jesus answered and said, "This voice did not come for my sake, but for yours. Now is the time of judgment on this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself." He said this, indicating the kind of death he would die. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
No question in the Gospel of St. John ever gets a simple answer. And the question in today's Gospel is no exception. Some Greeks asked to see Jesus. Everything that follows in the text seems to ignore the request. Or does it?
Which
When you accepted ashes on your forehead on Ash Wednesday, if you accepted ashes then, you were told, turn away from sin and believe the gospel. This means being willing to die to a life of sinful disobedience lived in isolation, and in its place to embrace a life of grace lived in union with God. And this grace was given to us in the sacrament of baptism, and then if it was subsequently lost because of sin, it can be restored in the sacrament of confession or reconciliation. Then, and only then, you can see Jesus. And thirdly, those who want to see Jesus must be willing to serve. To serve others just as Jesus does. And that's why feet will soon be washed in the liturgy of Holy Thursday. That's why somebody will offer a cross to us to venerate in the liturgy of Good Friday. We see Jesus every time we take up the cross of somebody else's burdens in selfless, humble service. And this is all the more urgent in a difficult time of pandemic and resulting economic stress. And finally, you have to use your ears in order to see Jesus, not just your eyes. We regularly hear the voice from heaven that is mentioned in tonight's gospel. And we hear it in the scriptures when they are proclaimed at every Mass. They show Jesus to us because he is the Word of God. And once we're enlightened by the scripture, we can pass that light on to others, just as our newly baptized parishioner, Zachary Stevens, will pass the light of his baptismal candle to everyone at the liturgy of the Easter Vigil this year. His candle will be lit from the Paschal candle, which symbolizes the light of Christ risen from the dead. St. John, in this gospel tonight, boldly writes, some Greeks asked to see Jesus. That's how it begins. So let me say it just a little bit differently. Some Greeks asked to see Jesus. It's not surprising that Jews would want to see Jesus, but even the Greeks knew, for Pete's sake. Even the Greeks can come to see Jesus. Bury your selfish shell and burst into the bright sunshine of Jesus' light. Lose your mortal life of sin and gain the immortal life of grace. Wash the feet of others and see Jesus in their needs. And finally, see with your ears by being enlightened by the Word of God, which comes to us from heaven. Would you like to see Jesus? So if so, these steps can be especially helpful, and we need to be conscious, especially of our friend Zachary Stevens and Brian Reardon, and others who will be receiving the sacraments of reconciliation during the Lenten season. They too have asked to see Jesus. And it's up to us to show Jesus to them, especially in the coming Easter celebration, which begins on Holy Thursday evening. It'll continue on Good Friday. It will reach its climax at the Easter Vigil, and it will continue again on Easter Sunday morning. The Greeks are asking to see Jesus still.
Harvest of life through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels
You, therefore, Almighty Father, we bless through Jesus Christ, your Son, who comes in your name. He himself is the Word that brings salvation, the hand you extend to sinners, the way by which your peace is offered to us. When we ourselves have turned away from you on account of our sins, you brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, so that, converted at last to you, we might love one another through your Son, whom for our sake you handed over to death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation Christ has brought us, we entreat you, sanctify these gifts by the outpouring of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, whose command we fulfill when we celebrate these mysteries. For when about to give his life to set us free, as he reclined at supper, he himself took bread into his hands, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, on that same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands, confessing their mercy, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of of Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of God, and the glory of your bosom, and our glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you in advance to those who can stay for a few moments to help us with the cleanup and sanitizing the pews. Also, there are still envelopes in the vestibule of the church for the Cardinal's appeal. We'll see that we are pretty far behind in our goal at this point. And so I'd ask you who are considering and still praying about your gift to the Cardinal's appeal to please do so and make it this week if it's all possible. And you can send it either right down to 1011 or multiple copies of the Capuchin Journey, and in it, it features an article on our new Capuchin Mobile Ministries, which is ministry to folks on the streets in Boston. We hope to share that ministry around the province, and so at some future date in the spring, we will have a truck here, just so you can see what we do, or what the friars are doing actually in Boston. That's a great ministry, hands-on with the poor. Participate in one way or another. So do kindly take home the Capuchin Journey. We have plenty. I know some of you received them already in the mail, but see what's going on new in the Capuchin world and in our province. Also, those of you who sent in those yellow sheets last weekend or during the week, your tickets for Palm Sunday and Easter Sunday are available at the entrance of the church as you leave today. If you do not fill out the form and would like to do so, there are multiple forms available. Sunday and Easter Sunday will be ticket admission. This Wednesday evening at 7:30 p.m. as part of our Lenten service, I will be preaching an extended homily at the Mass. The theme is Lent, so what? That should be, just get us to think a little bit more about how important Lent is, and that we end strong this wonderful season of penance. Also, next Monday is Reconciliation Monday from 4 to 8. Here at the church or in the chapel, Father John and myself will be available for those 4 hours for confessions for anyone who would like to celebrate before Easter. If you're not available at those times, you'd like to call, make an appointment, we'd be more than happy to see you at the office. Right? I forgot to ask you. Good. We celebrate all the time. Good role model. And finally, in case you didn't realize it, it's spring.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.